This is my outfit for today. I'm going to a high tea for my friend's birthday. I'm wearing a CDG top, a Musinsa standard oversized blazer, and a skirt I also got from Musinsa. I think it's from 99 Humanity. My socks and some loafers. And then I added this little pin to give a little accessory. Then I have my nails done. But I'm going for like a Parisian proper vibe. I kind of look like I'm out of jail, I feel, sometimes with this shirt, because you can't see the heart, but it's a little bit gothic, which I like. Ow! This is how my nails turned out. I did some Kuromi and Hello Kitty nails. I don't know why I always try to do such hard designs, but it does help me get better. I had a lot better luck with using the gel this time and having that setup of like not having to do it on my fingers but have like a stand to put the nails on and paint it was really helpful. I've been having some nails pop off, but I think it's because when I glued them on, I was just going too fast and I didn't really take the time to like press them on securely. But I think they're all on now. The pink kind of turned out more neon than I wanted, but it's practice. It's gonna get better every time. But I'm going to a high tea today. I've never been to a high tea. It's for my friend's birthday celebration. I'm very excited. I've always wanted to go to a high tea, and I'll try to take some videos while I'm there.
Train the AI.
I got at Sephora. It's a primer. I've never used a primer before, so it's by Patrick Star, I think, the one size. I'll be trying it out today. It has these little bubbles in it. Feels very moisturizing. I went into Sephora interested in the YSL New and the Giorgio Armani luminous finish or glow, something like that. The YSL New was just too thin. I kind of wanted something a little thicker just to like cover discoloration. And then the Giorgio Armani, I really liked the coverage, but it was like patchy on my skin. The person at Sephora recommended a primer. I was interested in the Patrick Ta foundation, and the Sephora person also recommended it for my type of skin because it's like a cream. But I'm very happy with this so far with Patrick Ta. I really like their products. So this is what I ended up with. I've tried this one before, but I have not tried it on like a primed, on my primed skin. So we're gonna try that. It's supposed to make it look very dewy, I guess, since this is a cream. So it has the same packaging as the blush. It's just a little bit bigger. The blush is smaller. I don't love the packaging. Like, it gets all like, you see that? You can see your handprints. And then I would think that you hold this part down and like open it. Like, I always think that, but no, you open it like this. And that's just like weird to my brain. I'm just using my Kirby cosmetic puff. They had brushes they sold with this, but it was a little bit expensive. Look at that. I've never really wore foundation before. Like, I've worn it probably once in my life. Like when I got, no, I don't think I've ever, oh yeah, when I got my makeup done, I think once. They did foundation on me. Usually I just wear like a cushion compact, so I guess it's not like foundation. I wanted something like
The cushion that I had, the M Cosmetics, was just a little too thin and like, it basically didn't really do anything. And I wanted something that kind of just made me a little bit more seamless. So I just wanted something that like blended out a little better, but I didn't even use that much and look how good it looks already. So I think I'm gonna use my e.l.f. powder instead of the Patrick Ta powder. And it looks like this. You just open it up and it has this screw top and you screw it to be on the hole side. This is what they instruct you to do. And then you put it in. I'm just gonna take this.